Hey guys, welcome back to another video here on the channel. Today we are in 2030. We are in the 2030 season, so welcome to the new decade, first off. And second off, let's get it started and underway. We have two guys that we are going to be trading. I made some signings for just some random guys to come in and fill some spots, especially linebacker and stuff. So we did bring in Derwin James and Miles Jack, both off of free agency. They're just going to come in for a year. Or so, I don't know. Just really depends. Moved some guys around, but other than that, really, it hasn't changed much. The only thing we're doing is going to be trading two right tackles real quick. We're trading Garvin and Lee Barr. Lee Barr is a rookie, but we are going to be trading him. He won't develop fast enough. Now, here's the situation that's going on. If we do not become good enough, like, let's say we don't make a deep run in the playoffs, or at least a playoff push, I think we're going to tear down any big contracts. Any big contracts, I think we're going to tear down, besides maybe QB and then build around him. I think anybody that's not on a rookie contract or the 550K contracts, I think we'll just ship off, say we're done with, because I don't even know how much cap penalty we're in. We're probably in a decent amount of cap penalty. I mean, we still have 15 mil left after signing those guys. Yeah, we have 24 mil in cap penalties coming this year, and we have 17 mil left in space. So, I mean, it's not terrible. I mean, here's the thing. I think, like, people like Angel Ness will probably be gone. Drew Parker will probably be gone. Bellamy will probably be gone. Stuckey will probably be traded for something good. Brennan, I think, will keep. Hicks will probably keep. It just really depends on the player, because, like, Isaiah Simmons has 4 years left, but with under 5 mil for these next 2 years, basically, I'll keep him. He'll probably drop to, like, an 82 by the end of his contract, so we might trade him in as, like, last year, just to bring some type of value back to the team. But anyway, guys, let's get it started. So with them being traded, the two tackles, we're going to go ahead and set up the depth chart, and then we'll hop in to the season. Let's go ahead, get everything set up. We had to bring Boggs in just for sake of having somebody on the team, just making sure everything's in the right place. Daquan Russell will get moved up. Isn't Hunt our new rookie? Yeah. So I'll actually move him up over Peoples-Jones. I don't know. God damn it. Whatever. Tight end's fine for now. Had to bring Fanton. Yeah, you'll see, like, a lot of rookies and guys that came in with our, like, first draft class. So you'll see them leaving as the years go on. They're finally regressing, especially the guys that were only in, like, the mid 80s and stuff. You'll see a lot of them slowly start to move on from the franchise. So it's kind of weird seeing those guys leave, but, you know, it is what it is. 50 years, so gotta keep it going. Yeah, so like I said, I just moved some guys around from positions. I tried to keep most guys that were on 550k contracts, because those are the guys that I do want to keep in general. Just do Lauderdale there. I can't speak tonight for some reason, I guess. Just setting up the team in the best way I think possible. I think what I want to do is I think I want to start Porter somewhere. I want to see who's sub linebacker, though. Who's good in sub linebacker? You know what? We'll just keep him there. We'll send Denzel Ward and Quentin Strong. We're not going to really put anybody too great. Let's see. Porter's pretty decent at it. Derwin James is pretty decent at it still. Donovan Dyson's still good at it. Jesus. Rich McKinley is not. I think we're going to start Kyrie Porter then. I think these will be our three linebackers. But I want the rookie at number one, because I want him to win Rookie of the Year. So I understand why Terrell Hendricks didn't really get a whole ton of play time when he was at left end. Nope, not what I meant to do. Jesus. See, that's one thing about, like, Madden and, like, the sim and everything and, like, auto-upgrading. Once you start getting past, like, that first year or so, it just fucking goes downhill because they just do not put the pieces in the right places. Like, they just fucking don't, like, nobody, like, just jumps up out of nowhere, which sucks. Like, that's not how real-world situations work. Like, when a rookie jumps off, they could be a 90 by the end of the first season. But instead, it doesn't allow you, even with Superstar X Factor. Like, even if you draft an 80 somehow, he will not be an 80. He will not be, like, a 92 by the end of the first year, like some rookies are. And I think that's the shitty thing about Madden, is you can't make those, like, unbelievable jumps into Superstardom. So, and then you end up with this, like, you have to retain your guys or you have to find a way to draft well. And I just don't think that's very fun. We're going to move him up. Actually, we'll just move him back into linebacker. Well, middle linebacker. Yeah, so Porter's going to play there. Then we'll put Derwin James behind him. And then we'll put Miles Jack behind him. Then we'll do Dyson here. Derwin. Richie, then Derwin. And then left we'll do... Okay. I forgot that I was supposed to fucking do that. Okay. Yeah, so Derwin's gonna play left. So, just line those guys up like that. Yeah, so bring him down. Let Miles Jack play there. As well as Rich McKinley, and then, yeah, just like that. Okay, that's good. Let's get started. I probably should have done depth chart beforehand, but whatever. Yeah, one Super Bowl in, like, 12 years, not that great, so we gotta start looking to play better. Let's sim to the midseason. Okay, at the midseason mark, we are 5-3. Not bad, not great. Donovan Dyson has 3, so it looks like he might have a superstar ability, which would be great for us. Jason Wheeler unlocks another ability, so that does mean he passes a 90. Yeah, so he has Omaha, he has Inside Deadeye, Pocket Deadeye, Homer, and Hot Route Master. Cool. Yeah, so we'll be keeping on hold of him no matter what. I think even if we do decide to tear down the team and just start fucking wheeling and dealing players. The only players that are really even, like, maybe coming back is maybe Sheffield, Porter, actually all four of these guys. I'm going to bring back Wheeler, but I'm going to bring him back on a huge-ass deal right now. What's his cheapest? If I do 5 years? Yeah. Or do I just want to lock him up? I think we're just going to lock him up and just get him here in the building for good. So... Von Stucky. I want to bring all these guys back, but it's just like... See, I think I can do better than Sheffield. Kyrie Porter. I think we're just going to let walk. I don't want to pay six. Stucky is a different situation, though. He is a very good, talented player. But the problem is, will he turn into that type of production that we saw from, you know, from the other guys? So... Because that was our probably biggest problem with, Chase Young and, AJ Epineza, is they never just, they never fucking got going. Like, they never ever did. So, send them to the playoffs. So, we did not end up making the playoffs. That kind of sucks. It does. Just gonna auto-upgrade everybody. So Daquan Russell apparently got up to an 80 this year. We went 9-7, so must have just barely missed out on a wild card spot, which is whatever. Jason Wheeler having a decent year, good enough. Wish he would hit over that 4,000 mark every year and about 35 touchdowns, less than 10 picks, is good for us. Running backs still doing okay. I mean, it's you can't ask for a whole ton when they're unbalanced as shit. I might turn up the XP siders just to, like, over-saturate the market and then turn them back down after a year or two. Manny Hicks, Robbie Reese, and Daquan Russell, all pretty good years, all above 800 yards, all above 60 catches, 5 touchdowns as well. So, not bad as at all. I forgot to fucking start the other left tackle. Oh, well. The four guys that we were looking at did good. Drew Parker just... fucking sacks in this game are so broken. Yeah, Stuckey I think we'll bring back, but everybody else I don't think I really want to bring back. Kicking was whatever. Return squad, nothing special. Need to go back to defense and check all their stats. Three picks for Eric Ingram, two for Angel Ness. So, two guys playing out of their minds. Only one forced fumble, only one forced fumble recovered. Block kicks, two in total, one from Kendrick, one from Lauderdale. One safety, two touchdowns. Not bad. I'll take that. We were sixth in offense, 18th in defense. So, yeah, that does even out to about middle road. Eighth in points. And then 22nd in points allowed. Yeah, so not particularly the greatest. We're going to head to the offseason. So we are going to be tearing it down after this year. Anybody not? I'll just show you guys who we end up trading. But, I mean, there's not a whole ton. Holy shit. Is he super? Oh, I thought he was Superstar X Factor. I'm like, yay. And then, nope. Get fucked. Yeah, we're just going to upgrade his pass coverage because, no offense, if you upgrade his pass coverage, he becomes a lot better of a linebacker. Yeah, okay, so we're going to be keeping him, of course. So he must have played out of his fucking mind, which is great to hear. Because look at that. Jesus. 86 zone coverage, 70 man coverage. Dude is going to light up the field. Plus 78 block shedding isn't fucking terrible. Stuckey I want to bring back, but it's just like... I think what I'm going to do, and I've been doing this with a lot of other franchises recently, is signing these guys to big, expensive one-year deals. But in Stuckey's case, I think I'm going to sign him to a big, expensive one-year deal, but then not even try to trade him. I think I'll sign him to, like, a $25 million deal. And then not trade him. Well, if we don't plan on trading him, I say we just do, like, a 15 and 10. Now, we'll just do... Especially if it's a one-year deal, the cap hit won't be too bad. That actually saves us money, so you can get fucked. Porter, we're going to give you a one-year deal. And it's just going to be like a just going to be a real expensive contract right off the bat. I don't really want to watch you walk, so... Nope, okay, cool. We'll do it with Sheffield then, because I don't want all these guys to walk and then not have any value coming back into the team. So we're just going to give you all of this money, like so. And then we'll trade you. Cool. See you guys at free agency. Okay, like I said, trading Sheffield, just want some value in return for him, so gonna look through teams real quick. Somebody who needs a strong safety, that is also a green. You guys are the correct option here. Do we just go with a first rounder? What does Russell Brooks look like? Run stopper, power rusher. Yeah, no, I don't think he'd be that great. Because he's only at 60 coverage. Yeah, we'll just go with the first rounder of next year. And you guys can have a seventh of this year. If I have any. Nope, seventh of next year. We'll get it done. Bang. Sheffield. And we get money. Okay. I gotta go negotiate. Okay. Finally done. Had to negotiate on quite a few guys. We're bringing in some backups. Bringing in some guys to replace some guys when we do start trading away guys. So. All these guys are either A, young and I think have potential, or B, just good replacement pieces as of right now. Like this running back, why not go after him right now? Jaire Alexander, why not go after him? You know, just certain guys, why not go after him? Why not just send him a $550K contract, see if they accept? So, I'll see you guys at the draft. Okay. After free agency has passed, we did get LeMahieu, we did get McKnight, we did get Luther Watson, just some other guys as well. Nothing too impressive. We didn't end up getting the running back. He did end up signing in week two, signing a pretty big deal. So I wasn't willing to pay that, especially when we already have two guys on the roster. He was just going to be a replacement piece at best. So let's go ahead and get into the draft. With this pick, we are going Isaac Cunningham, defensive tackle. I was going to go with a corner, but I feel like this... Never fucking mind. My head hurts. Fuck me. See you guys at pick 20. With this pick, we are creating a little bit of, like, weirdness, I guess, in our backfield. We are going Denard Clemmings. He's probably one of the best running back prospects I've... Ooh, he's 23. Or do we go with Mims? I would rather go with Clemmings, I think. Yeah. We're going to go with Clemmings here. 23 years old, power back, 6'2", 233. He looks incredible, 7.8 at the combine. He is a first-round talent. He looks insane. Let's take him. 74 hidden. We just have to hope he has superstar or superstar X-Factor. I think that's the biggest thing here, is that we do have to hope for that. With this trade, we are trading Mike Lamar in 2/3 backup into the first. With this pick, we're taking a corner, Perry Evans. This is the reason why I passed up on the corner earlier at 12, which was probably a mistake, hindsight. He's number 16 in the class, took him at 24, 74 overall, hidden development. So. With this pick, we're taking another defensive tackle, Bo Parsons, I guess. Defensive tackle, 71 normal, basically as good as the other defensive tackle, so. Oh, and forgot to trade away the rest of my picks, and this is why you do it, kids. All garbage. They're getting released right now. I don't care. Yeah. I was thinking about trading them, but then I realized that the cap penalty is the second thing, and either way you have cap penalty facing you. So I'm just going to go ahead and release them. So we drafted two defensive tackles, both of them very unimpressive. The running back and the cornerback are both decent, but they do need to develop, or they need to have something good, hopefully under their sleeves. So that's basically it. We'll go ahead and sign off here real quick. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, subscribe, all that fun stuff. Turn on post notifications. I am trying to daily upload. It does get tough sometimes with working two jobs, so just keep that in mind. I'm going to try to work on rosters more. I should be streaming some of it, and then I'll be uploading clips of it to YouTube as well. So see you guys later.